Hello dear students, good morning. Let us discuss today's lecture. Equation of the chord joining two points P alpha comma Q beta. See, here this was I explained in the lecture number 3. There I had explained you that if this is x axis and this is y axis, so here this concept, this is called ellipse. So if you join any two points on the curve, if I join, this is I take any point anywhere like P alpha. Alpha means what here? What is the meaning of alpha? Beta means parametric form. Suppose if I take a P is a parametric point, that is a cos theta comma B sine theta. Okay. If I take in alpha, alpha is given means A cos alpha comma B sin alpha is a parametric form. Let us take another point on the para ellipse, that is Q is equal to A cos beta comma B sin beta. That is what indication of P alpha. P alpha meaning is what here? That is a parametric point on the ellipse, that is P A cos theta. You know that parametric point on the ellipse is what? A cos theta comma B sin theta. There here P alpha I take here, the angle is alpha, so A cos alpha comma B sin alpha. And if I take here Q beta here, then A cos beta comma sin beta. Then these two points, line joining two points, you know line joining two points formula, what is that? Y minus Y1 is equal to Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1 into X minus X1. This is the equation of the line. Suppose if I substitute, these are the two points I have on the ellipse, that is A cos alpha comma B sin alpha, and Q is A cos beta comma sin beta. These are the two points on the ellipse. Then the equation of the curve, when you join these two points on the curve, that is going to get as equation of the curve. So equation of the curve formula is this. After applying this formula, you will get the simplification. Nobody will ask you proof. Just you have to remember this formula. That is x by a cos alpha plus beta by 2 plus y by b sin alpha plus beta by 2 is equal to cos alpha minus beta by 2. This is I explained in second lecture. But today I want to explain more things. So that's why I am recalling this again another way. Okay, so here the equation of the curve is x by a cos alpha plus beta by 2 plus y by b sin alpha plus beta by 2 is equal to cos alpha minus beta by 2. If anybody asks you that what is the equation of the curve, equation of the chord is, you will use this formula and parametric point will be given. Okay, will be given. If you know already, suppose parametric point is not given, general points are given, then you know directly formula. Why? This is only formula, equation of the chord, equation of two points joining, line equation, you know generally. But if you have parametric points, then equation of the chord will get here like this formula, x by a cos alpha plus beta by 2 plus y by b sin alpha plus beta by 2 is equal to cos alpha minus beta by 2. But if you have any general points, then directly you will get the answer that you know this formula. Like you have 2 comma 3, 4 comma 3, any two points, then equation of the line you know already. That is equation of the chord. Now, this is also called as chord of contact. Chord of contact, when we will say, like in circles also I explained, chord of contact, when you say chord of contact, I'll explain now. See here, chord of contact means what? Yeah, see here, if this is an ellipse, okay, and you can take anywhere, not an axis. It's not mandatory to take the axis. Anywhere you can take it. Suppose this is an ellipse equation, and then you are drawing, see here, at two particular point, you draw a tangent here, and you draw a tangent here, and these both are going to be intersect at R point, and this point of contact is P alpha, and this point of contact is Q beta, then this R is the externally intersecting point. These are the pair of tangents. I'll discuss, just wait. These are the last concept of the ellipse I am explaining now. So what I want to tell you here, if this is the point here, this is the point here, if I join the tangent to these parabola and these two pair of tangents are going to be intersected at point R, then this, you join this PQ, is called as chord of contact. So what is the chord of contact? In circle also you have learned chord of contact. So chord of contact formula is equal to what? T is equal to 0. T means what here? Actually what is T? X x1 by A plus y y1 by C. Actually equation of the ellipse is what? X square by A plus y square by B is equal to 1. This is the ellipse equation. So what is the equation of the tangent here? X x1 by A plus y y1 by B is equal to 1. Okay. I will give the time to write, so you just listen first. Okay, x x1 by a plus y y1 by b is equal to 1. This is the equation of the tangent. But I have to substitute the points here. So let us take this r, h, comma k is the required point. So if I substitute here, x, h, chord of contact visibly, h x by a square plus k y by b square is equal to 1. Okay, if this is h comma k from external point, if you want to find the chord of contact, this is I explained in circles also. If you have a point here and you want to find the chord of contact, chord of contact means the at this tangents at the point of the edges, chord of contact means, you know, tangent, chord of contact of a tangent. From there, if you draw any line, that is called chord of contact. That is called chord, and that is it is point of contact, it is passing, so chord of contact we call. The equation of chord of contact is T is equal to 0. So here x1 place you substitute h, and y1 place you substitute k, you are going to get the answer, that is h x by a square plus k y by b square is equal to 1. Then the point here, the value of r will be getting, the value of r will be getting, because these both are equal, because this is also equation of the chord, and you know parametric points are given. This is the equation of the chord, this is the equation of the chord, and chord of contact also equation of the chord, and these both are equal. If I equal it, I get h value and k value here. If I equal it, means what I want to say here, h by a square is equal to, yeah, h by a square is equal to this one, cos alpha plus beta by 2 by a. So by equating that, you are going to get h value, k value. So h value you are getting here, you are going to get here. If you equalize these both, like here, if you want, I'll show you. See here, what I want to say here, h by a square divided by, here I can write as 1 cos alpha plus beta divided by 2 divided by a. And this value will be equal to, because this is equal to what here? Cos alpha minus beta by 2, if I compare. And that is divided by, here is 1. Here if I compare this x coefficient here, and this is the last constant here. If I compare from this here, a square a cancel from here, h I'll get. That h only this point. So that point is nothing but, if you want to find this point, the formula is a cos alpha plus beta by 2 into cos alpha minus beta by 2, and k value you get as b sin alpha plus beta by 2 divided by cos alpha minus beta by 2. Do you understood? Understood what I said? Understood, na? See, I'll explain once again for you. See, this is the ellipse. Okay. So you have drawn a tangent here, you have drawn a tangent here. So from this point of contact of this tangent, if you draw a line, that is called chord, and the chord is passing through the chord of contact, this is COC, that is called chord of contact. And this external point, wherever it is touch h comma k, you know that this is chord of contact formula, already I gave in circles also. Okay, so that is only this. So here in this case is chord of equation of the chord will be, equation of the chord is, this is the formula. Okay, and these both are equal. If I compare this x and this y, then I am going to get h and k values. So that h and k is, this is the point. So if you want to find external point of this one, of pair of tangent, you can use this formula. This formula also valid in the circle also. Circle and ellipse, what is the difference, you know? You replace B as A as B. Here if you replace B as A or A as B, then what you get here, you get this circle formula. In the circle, what is there, external point, that only you will get here. So most of the places you see here, even equation of the tangent also, if you replace B as A, you are going to get there, and here equation of the tangent looks like same, but only B and A changes will be there, because that is x square plus y square equal to A square, and this is x square by A square plus y square by B square equal to 1. So B you have to change as A, like, so like that you are going to get the answer. Okay, so here this is what you have, but don't link both of them. You learn separately, ellipse separate and circle separate. Already I have taught in the circle. So here in the ellipses, this is the formula. Okay, understand? Based on this, JEE did not ask, but we have to know this concept. Okay, so note down. See, now what I am going to explain you, listen to me. See, the same thing, you may ask me that, sir, without coordinate, you can draw with coordinates also. No problem, means with axis. What I want to tell you here is that if this is the x-axis and y-axis like that, and you are drawing the ellipse here, and one point is P alpha here, and one point is Q, that is beta here. So P alpha meaning is what? P alpha is nothing but A cos alpha comma B sin alpha. And here Q beta means what here? A cos beta comma B sin beta. Okay. So you have drawn one tangent from here. Okay. I'm getting here. I'll make it proper. Okay. So here this is the point, and you have drawn the tangent here. At this point you have drawn one tangent. From here you have drawn another tangent. These both are intersecting at a point R H comma K. Okay. Now when these two you join here, so if the point is here Q, suppose, when you join this chord will be intersect the axis, correct? So this can maybe passes through a point something D comma 0, it can be passes through something point D comma 0, or sometimes this is a possibility is there that it can may passes through the focus, means if I draw here focus, from focus it is passes. If this is the P point alpha here, and the here the Q point is beta here, and may this chord can be passes through the focus also. So this is very important thing here. I want to say here, when it is passes through focus, if a chord is passes through focus, that is very important. JEE already they asked this type thing. So if this chord is passes through the focus, then what you get condition? If this chord is passes through a point D comma 0, then what you are going to get? That point I am going to explain you. See, a simple thing to make you understand here, I just want to tell you here, this is the thing, if you remember easily it will be done, or you want the proof, I will explain the proof also. See here, when I say if this is passing through the point focus, focus means what? Focus point will be what here? A comma 0. Focus is what? A comma 0. Focus means what? A comma 0. Or it can be passes through any point. Like any point means here x value can be anything, D comma 0. Or it can be passes through the focus. Focus is fixed. So focus is the A comma 0. And other than focus, it can be passes through D comma 0. Then what is you are going to get? Means I can substitute A comma 0 point in this, then I will get the condition for that. Even I can substitute D comma 0 in this, then I am going to get the condition that. So the condition is what? I will explain now, okay? So here the proof is, if I substitute A comma 0 in this, y value is 0 and x value you get A. So you get here what here? A divided by A cos alpha plus beta by 2 plus here y value will become 0. 0 into anything will be 0. So this is equal to cos alpha plus alpha minus beta by 2. From this, this A is going to get cancel out. So E is equal to, you are going to get as cos alpha minus beta by 2 divided by cos alpha plus beta by 2. This is very important condition I am explaining. This is asked in JEE. Okay, these type of things going to be asked. So if the chord is passing through the focus, what is the condition? If the chord is passing through any constant, what is the condition? Now cos alpha minus beta by 2 formula is what here? Cos alpha by 2 into cos beta by 2 plus sin alpha by 2 into sin beta by 2. Is it, you know that formula? Yes. The formula is, you know that is, I told you already here, E is equal to the formula is cos alpha by 2 into cos beta by 2 minus plus sin alpha by 2 into sin beta by 2 divided by, here is you get as cos alpha by 2 into cos beta by 2 minus sin alpha by 2 into sin beta by 2. This is the formula. Okay, this is the formula we have applied here. Now what we can do here right now is I can do one thing. See, remember E is equal to, you got this. Okay, so I'll use a concept here. If I divide by cos alpha by 2 and cos beta by 2 on both sides, so what I get here, E is equal to, okay, E is equal to, I'll get as 1 plus tan alpha by 2 tan beta by 2 divided by 1 minus tan alpha by 2 into tan beta by 2 I'll get. Okay, after that what I am going to do here, I am going to do a componendo and dividendo condition. You know componendo, dividendo, what do you do here? If you have, simple thing I am telling, E is there. So E by 1, componendo and dividendo, basic lecture I explained in previous year. So what I do here, E I write as minus 1 upon E plus 1. This is the componendo and dividendo. Means what do you write here? Here we'll write numerator, that is 1 plus tan alpha by 2 into tan beta by 2 in tan beta by 2. This is the numerator minus 1. See here, 1 means what? Denominator. Minus denominator. Are you getting it? Numerator, yeah, this is the numerator minus denominator by numerator plus denominator. So numerator minus denominator by, that is minus denominator, that is 1 minus tan alpha by 2. I think I will explain, please note down, because the place will not be sufficient. Note down, I'll explain. So now listen here, what I want to tell you here, I'm applying the componendo and dividendo over there. So componendo, dividendo, I explained in the basic lectures of last year. As if you forgot, I repeat again. E by 1, okay, E by E, numerator minus 1 plus 1. Because the denominator is 1, so we have to do what here? 1 plus tan alpha by 2 plus tan beta by 2. This is the numerator. I have to write numerator down also. 1 plus tan alpha by 2 plus tan beta by 2. Numerator I wrote, and I will subtract the denominator now. And I will add the denominator now. So 1 plus tan alpha by 2 tan beta by 2 divided by 1. So here I can write as 1. Okay, denominator, no? Denominator is minus, right? Denominator is minus, right? Right? Denominator is minus, yeah. So 1 minus tan alpha by 2 tan beta by 2. So what I am going to get here, this plus 1 minus 1 gets cancelled. Tan alpha by 2 into tan beta by 2, it is into, sorry, okay. Tan alpha by 2 tan beta by 2 here cancel out. So you get as E minus 1 by E plus 1 is equal to 2 tan and minus into minus plus, 2 tan alpha by 2 into tan beta by 2 divided by 2, 2, 2 gets cancelled. So finally I want to tell you, this is the result which is very, very important. That is, what is the result here? So if the chord is passing through the focus, then the result is E minus 1 by E plus 1 is equal to tan alpha by 2 into tan beta by 2. This is the most important result. So E minus 1 by E plus 1. If the chord is passing through foci, focus, so E minus 1 by E plus 1 is equal to tan alpha by 2 into tan beta by 2. Okay, and if this is passing through D comma 0, if this chord is passing through D comma 0, the formula is D minus A by D plus A is equal to tan alpha by 2 into tan beta by 2. This is the formula. Remember, these formulas are important. Okay, fine. This is the result, not formula, it's a result. Same as it is, you substitute and do it. Yeah, these are the results you should know. When you substitute, you get as D plus A by D minus A. Okay. So D plus A by D minus A is equal to tan alpha by 2, tan beta by 2. When it is passing through a point, if the chord of contact is, see, this chord is passing through D comma 0, then the answer is D plus A by D minus A is equal to tan alpha by 2, tan beta by 2. So these are the important result, okay? And last concept I am going to explain next lecture, then I am going to give you some problems, important problems. This chapter will be complete after completing the important problems, okay?